have a pretty epic water crisis in Mexico City, and so we figured, let's start harvesting rainwater in these neighborhoods where people need it. Isla Urbana is an organization that designs and installs rainwater harvesting systems. We've installed something like 24,000 or 25,000 rainwater harvesting systems just using revenue.
Solo de noche llega el agua, viernes o sábado. Se le ve amarilla, ahora huele. Para tomar, compramos.
Le digo a mi esposo, esto va a ser la guerra del agua.
The rainwater harvesting systems that we install are pretty simple. It teaches people how to harvest, filter, and potabilize water at home. The whole thing starts with the roof of the house, which is the catchment surface. So we work with the family so that they have a very clear understanding of keeping the roof as clean as possible. The water that falls off of that roof, we channel through gutters and pipes. We chlorinate that water. We do a simple sedimentation process that allows fine particles of sediments to settle in the tank. And then after that, we pass it through a pretty simple filtration system that then feeds water to the rest of the house. And we can get water of whatever quality we need. From kind of general use domestic water, we can get purified water that you could bottle.
Me subo cuando ya va a llegar temporada de lluvia y ahí la recolectamos. Para muchas cosas sirve, está limpiecita.
Captamos desde 15,000 a 20,000 litros de agua por año, ¿eh? 10 personas que ocupamos esa agua. Todo el año con esa agüita la pasamos. Nos alcanza, gracias a Dios.
Llegaba el momento que ya cuando se acababa la temporada de agua, se quedaban los 800 litros y eso lo teníamos que hacer que durara 3 o 4 meses. Y ahora con el sistema de captación de aguas pluviales podemos captar 3,000 litros de agua. Y esta ya tiene cierto tipo de filtros que sale de mejor calidad.
Harvesting rainwater, it's an ancient practice that people have done forever and like just kind of largely abandoned as we kind of adopted other ideas of how we should get water and what modern water access should look like. But in that pursuit, there's all of these millions of people that just kind of fell through the cracks and were left in these continuously precarious situations, living with often very, very small amounts of water, often with water of very poor quality, often paying an enormous amount proportional to their income getting water.
Pues la escasez ya tiene años, de que ya no llega diario, diario. Hace poco nos falló como 15 días. Tuvimos que pedir una pipa, costó 700 pesos.
Cada vez nos limitaban más el servicio del agua. La de la red no es de que sea mala, pero también ya hojas, tierra, bacterias, como para tomar ya no sirve.
Mexico City is one of the top 10 cities rated most likely to run out of water in the world by the Nature Conservancy. We've done a lot of work getting policy passed. Mexico now has requirements for rainwater harvesting systems to be integrated into new construction. Very fundamentally, we need to start being able to use the water that we have and reduce the amount of water that we need to pull out of the ground. And the most direct and simplest way to do that is to start actually using the rainwater that falls on us.
Hace muchos años había mucha agua. Eran muchas zanjas de agua limpia.
Mucha agua del subsuelo. Aquí rascaba uno antes un metro, medio metro y salía el agua. Todavía en 1970 había mucha agua. Creció la mancha urbana y todo se derrumbó. Se acabó todo.
I would trace the story of Mexico City's water crisis to an event that happened in 1607. When the Viceroy of New Spain, based out of Mexico City, decided that Mexico City was going to be a dry land city like Madrid and made the decision to drain the lake of Texcoco. As the city was built on this old lake bed, the soft ground underneath would sink, and the result of channeling all of the rain out of the city as quickly as possible to avoid flooding has also stopped the process of recharging the groundwater. And that's kind of the core of the water crisis in Mexico City.
Siempre ahorrando el agua, siempre ahorrando, que debemos de saber cuidar el agua, porque ¿qué va a ser para nuestras generaciones futuras? ¿Qué van a hacer?
Ahorita lo estamos viendo. Más adelante lo vamos a vivir peor.
las necesidades son más, porque somos más en el planeta. Y es la misma agua que hay.
We've gotten this deeply intimate vision into how people are experiencing the water crisis, and I think it's something that will end up being relevant to many, many cities throughout the world, what's being developed here in Mexico City.